Hi, Ashley. My name is Brianna with Toriar Digital Marketing, and I appreciate you guys speaking on the phone with my partner, Ashley, and giving her permission for us to send you guys this video. We're just making this quick video to show you how to improve your website so you can bring in some more customers for free. And I know you're probably wondering, why are we even doing this for you guys? It's actually pretty simple. I used to own my own roofing company in Alaska, and I know that business owners reach a point where they're too busy running their business to learn how to make the internet work for them and bring in more customers. And the only thing holding owners back is usually from hiring a marketing agency is that they don't know who is an expert and who's not. So we found that by making these free attack plans and giving them away for free, there's still a lot of business owners who end up calling me back and Ashley back and asking us to do this stuff for them. So if after this video you guys see that we've got tricks up our sleeves and we could do some good work for you guys, then you can always give us a call back and we can chat. If you just want to take the information and fix your website yourself, please do. This is free education for you. I'm only going to be talking about three things today. I want to be courteous of your time here, so bear with me. It won't be long. We're going to be talking about content, citations, and backlinks. You guys do have a nice website. It's nice and clean. You've chosen a good neutral color for your theme. I like it. Now, unfortunately, Google is not ranking you guys based on the appearance of your site. Google actually has bots called crawlers that are scanning the content on your site to find keywords to have you show in the results for searches. Now, the rule of thumb is at least 1,500 words of content on the homepage and at least 500 words on each back service page. Reason being is Google needs to know you're an expert and they're going to rank you higher if they think so. The other reason is because Google doesn't like keyword stuffing. So they like to see at least 100 words of content for every one keyword. So if you want to show up in a lot of types of searches, you need to have the content to support that and have Google give you the ranking for them. If we go over here, I have pulled up a keyword example of roofing contractors Fresno. As you can see, there's quite a few different search types. Like I said, there's a lot of keywords out there. The first thing your customers are going to see is the Google My Business or the Google Map Pack. You want to make sure this is optimized with your company contact information and photos. Then you need citations, which are online directories. Anything like Yelp, Yellow Pages, White Pages, Angie's List. It's a pretty extensive list of possibilities, and we're not going to be able to go down it today, but you know that there's the online directories are out there, so go get your company contact information put on them, and that's going to help you get boosted up here. As long as you have at least 100 more than your competitors, you can work your way up right to the top. If we continue down, we're going to see the organic search results with a lot of those citations I mentioned. The first company that comes up for roofing contractors Fresno is Brad's Quality Roofing, and because of that, I will be using them as your competitor for the remainder of the video. Here I've pulled up their site and we can see they don't have very much content, so you guys sticking to that 1500 minimum on the homepage is going to help you outrank them. I use this tool called Ahrefs, which shows the back end on what's happening on your website. We see that you have a high UR rating of 23, which is good. This is your website strength, but your domain ranking for your backlink profile is pretty low. I know, what are backlinks? Backlinks are basically when a website online links to your site and drives traffic to you. And Google likes this because it is a popularity contest. So you want to be making sure you're linking with industry relevant websites, things like other roofing companies or just roofing supplies. Now, you want to make sure that they have good rankings and ratings, or Google's going to drop you too. Now, you have added 4, which is helping you grow on your keywords. So you guys have the right idea. You have 179 backlinks coming from only 40 websites. You're ranking for 115 keywords, and you're only getting 29 monthly traffic. If we go over to your competitor, Brad's Quality Roofing, we can see they have a much higher domain rating and about the same UR. So with this domain ranking, what I would be doing is the copycat method. We would go in and find the industry-relevant backlinks that are giving your competitor the most power, and we would copy them onto your site. But we're not going to half-ass it. We'll still full asset, and we'll go above and beyond by adding more backlinks than your competitor that are also high quality, so you can boost your rating beyond that 18. So they have 551 backlinks coming from 37 websites, and they have 173 keywords, but they're getting 128 organic traffic each month. You can see that since they dropped on some of their keywords, they've actually lost nearly 500 organic traffic. So you can see why it's so important to rank really high on the searches. People are lazy and they don't like to spend a lot of time going down Google search. So quick recap, you guys need to get more content on your homepage here, 1500 word minimum, 500 word minimum on each back service page, and then you want to go and get some high authority, high ranking backlinks that are industry relevant and hook them up to your site. That's going to help boost you guys there. And then for your Google My Business, you want to make sure that that's optimized and you guys are going to be able to show up in the top three because we know people are lazy and they're not going to click view all. A good way to sneak in on your Google My Business and your website, when you're uploading images to your site or the Google My Business, make sure that you have the file names saved as keywords that you want to rank for. So that's about it. If you guys do those three steps, you will see yourselves ranking number one across Google. I know you're probably wondering, what do you do now? Well, you can either take the information we gave you and apply it yourself. That's totally okay. This was free education. All that Ashley and I are really looking for is some feedback to let us know your thoughts about the video. And if you do want any help getting this stuff done, or you just don't want to have to worry about it, and you want to focus on your business and let somebody else handle it for you, go ahead and give us a call and we'll have a chat, see if we'll be a good fit for you guys. Thank you so much for your time. I hope you enjoyed the video. We will be having our partner, Jeremy, follow up with you for some feedback for your thoughts. Take care.